In 1965, a group of Armenians from Karabakh collected their signatures and appealed to Moscow with a claim about separating Karabakh from Azerbaijan and joining it to Armenia. The center will reject the claim, but the Armenians will not renounce their claim. After 2 years, on July the 3rd, 1967, a 10-year-old boy near Son Mosesyan's corpse will be found in the territory of Kurapatkina village in Khojavan district. The Armenians will blame three Azerbaijanis for this murder. Ershad Mehmedov, a teacher, headmaster of school, Zohram Mehmedov, his brother-in-law, and Alemshad Mehmedov, a watchman. They're all from Garadala village in Khojavan district. The investigators, Armenians, will accuse the Azerbaijanis, but they will not reply to the key question: what was the motive? The Armenians in court will state, shooting to all three. The court will pass a sentence: Alemshad Mehmedov shooting, Ershad Mehmedov 15-year imprisonment, Zohram Mehmedov excused. The enraged Armenians will try to break Alemshad and Ershad from the escorts. Zohram will manage to hide himself in a prisoner's car, but no one and nothing will save them. They will be killed, their bodies will be mocked at, then will be burnt in the presence of the children. Later, the secret about the Armenian child's death will be revealed and proven. The child was killed by Armenians, but the blame was laid on Azerbaijanis in order to prove Moscow that it is quite impossible for Armenians to live together with Azerbaijanis and to defend justice of the claim. And explosions will really happen. Later, flames spread over Karabakh. Armenian extremism will encourage a move to terrorism, and terrorism will make a start to genocide. Within a few months, as a result of four terrorist acts committed by Armenians, Karadağlı village will lose 12 innocent, peaceful people. Karadağlı, it means those living in sadness in black days. What happened before the occupation of this village will be nothing in comparison with what its residents will expect afterwards. February the 17th, 1992. This was the very date when Karadağlı residents will witness the fires of hell, will live the rest of their lives with grief and die. They will be the people living in sadness, in black days. On September the 8th, 1991, the Icarus bus was following the route Ardam-Karadağlı. There were over 40 passengers in it, and they were all relatives, close and distant. They were on the way back from the funeral. All roads about 6 kilometers were normal. Tayyar Aliyev, a passenger, was conversing with his neighbor, and all of a sudden, something horrific took place before his very eyes.
Kabakta yaşlı kadın oturmuştu. Bizden bir neçe oturacak kabakta. Rakşanda Hüseynova. Benim şahsen gördüğüm oldu ki, gülle ona nece değdiyse, o kadın yaşlı kadın idi. Oturduğu oturacaktan gülle onu avtobüsün tavanına vurdu.
Blood spread up to knees over the floor of the bus. In a flash, the bus was riddled with gunfire. There was no place to hide. Women, elderly men and children turned to alive targets.
Ama bir oğlan da dal kapıda dayanmıştı. Caban oğlan 19 yaşında. Ona ne kadar eledim dedim ayak uzan yere, ayak uzan yere dedi kişi de uzanar mı? Külle ona değdi kapının ağzında.
Benden sol tarafta Gülzende Hüseynova. Bahçir kızı. Onun boyun nahiyesinden çok güman ki sonralarda bildik ki bu boyun nahiyesinden gülle değmişti. Kan fontan gibi fışkırırdı. Yani o kanı dayandırmak mümkün değildi.
A 2 kilometer road was under firing. The firing ceased when the bus approached Karadağlı village. At that time, 6 women and 2 fellows were killed. 17 people were wounded in the bus. There was no difference for Armenians whomever they killed. The main thing was just to achieve the goal, to form a fictitious state with false borders on the territories where they were received as at their own house. The beginning of the 19th century was the start of Armenians' mass resettlement from Turkey and Iran. As the archive sources of the Russian Empire say, that 85,000 Armenians were settled for a short period. Indeed, their number increased a lot. The newly arrived Armenians were settled chiefly on the historical territories of Azerbaijan. Yerevan, Zengezur, and Karabakh became their homeland. By the beginning of the 20th century, the number of Armenians exceeded in southern Caucasus more than a million. They grew rich and strengthened their positions at the expense of privileges and allocations received from other states. However, they began putting forward political demands. By this time, such political parties as Armenakan, Binchak, Dashnaksutyun had been established. They strove only for one goal, to form the so-called the Greater Armenia on the territories of Turkey, Azerbaijan, and Georgia. Terrorism has been chosen by these organizations as a method of struggle. The same terrorism didn't leave out Garadaghli village. In 1905, 1906, massacres were carried out by Dashnak units in Shusha and other settlements of Karabakh as well as Garadaghli village. Under the leadership of Stepan Shamyan, Anastas Mikoyan, Amazasp, commander of Dashnak units, and all over the territory of Azerbaijan, mass extermination of Azerbaijanis was organized in 1918-1920. 15,000 people in Baku, 10,000 in Shamakhi, 4,000 in Gubar, 50,000 in Zengezur. In general, nearly 700,000 innocent people were killed in the mass extermination of Azerbaijanis on the whole territory of Azerbaijan in 1918-1920. In 1948-1953, by the decree issued by Stalin, mass deportation of Azerbaijanis from Armenia started, and over 200,000 Azerbaijanis were forced to flee their homeland and move to Azerbaijan. The same recurred in 1988. Both cases of deportation were accompanied by acts of violence regarding Azerbaijani population. This was the very start of Armenia's war of occupation against Azerbaijan. The policy of artificial settling of Armenians on the territory of Azerbaijan led to the fact that Garadaghli village was wholly encircled by Armenian-populated areas. During the 4 years from 1988 to 1992, confrontation between the local residents of this village and Armenian combatants continued. Owing to some raids of self-defense forces of Hojavan district, the majority of the population, particularly children, women, and old men, were evacuated. February 17, 1992, subunits of Armenian combatants raided Garadaghli village on 4 sides. 188 persons, including 10 women, were gathered in the administrative building of Garadaghli farmhouse. They had no cartridges. An extract from the book My Brother's Road, written by Markar Melkonyan, a brother of Monte Melkonyan, an international Armenian terrorist, one of the authors and performers of the genocide in Garadaghli village. Now he, Monte, cold-bloodedly put his gun B7 on his shoulder, took aim and squeezed the trigger. The first shell, with a white flash and roar, hit straight the window in the corner on the second floor, burnt everything inside, and with a yellow flash burst back out of the window.
Granatamyotla da vurdular. Üst tarafını uçurdular. Da o Mamet'te biz teslim olmuşuz. Hemen o Mamet'te.
The hostages were separated into old men, women, and young people. 2 lorries were standing nearby. The elderly men and women were ordered to get on the first lorry, and fellows on the second. At this moment, one of the Armenian combatants seized Eldar Nariyev by the scruff of the neck and dragged him. There was a dead silence around when the Armenians fired on him. Silently, one had to weep. Everybody was about to lose their voices. Not a single sound was heard, but the sound of a stick striking a bone and the moans.
Tam yanımda öldürdüler.
Yani maşına binəndə dəyənəklə, ağaçla vurdular başına. Yani orada öldürdülər onu. Birinci onu öldürdülər.
Biz də baxırıq maşının içində. Nə qoyuruq? Ələcimiz nədir? Ondan da qayıtdılar, Allah ölənlərin rəhmət eləsin, istəmirəm deyəm yarası təzələnənə gəlinin atasın. Dedilər, filan kəs düş aşağı. Heç bilmədim, nə ilə vurdular, nə təri vurdular, kişinin necə boşarılandı, bədən aralandı. Qurdular marşın altına qışlanıcı elədilər. Tikə-tikə elədilər.
After the violence, Armenians ordered to drive off the lorry. Those who sat in the body of the lorry saw fatally wounded Ali Gismet. He was lying at the doors of the administrative building, and the only thing he could do was to smile and wave his hand with difficulty. In any case, nothing has been known about the fate of Ali Gismet and other wounded persons, as well as those three children who were put not in the lorry, but in the car of an Armenian commander by his order.
Bizdə az yaşlı uşaqlar var idi, 3 nəfər. Hüseynov, İbrahim Həbiboğlu, Əliyev Xaliq Məhərrəmoğlu, bir də Hüseynov Niftalı Bakiroğlu. Gətirdilər maşının arxasına, bunları da gətirəndə mən hələ yerdə idim, də maşına mindirməmişdilər. Bunların komandiri var idi, Mamvel deyirdilər. Mamətcan deyirdilər. Mamvel idi adı, nə idisə belə deyirdilər. Qara formada başı çalmalı, buralar başında da yazılar var da Erməni dilində idi, nəsə oxumaq olmur. Bir də qollarını bax bu hissədə, qara forma. Bu dedi ki, bunları Ermənilərə dedi ki, onları mindirməyin, onları öz maşınımda aparacağam. 06 Jiqulisi vardı yaşıl rəngdə.
The lorry with young hostages stopped at the place called Beylik Bağı, the groom's garden. There was a tractor nearby. 10 of the hostages were ordered to get off. No volunteers got off. All knew what would be expected. Then the Armenian combatants behaved in a different manner.
Onda mən yaralandım. Onda çənəm qırıldı mənim. Tam ağzımda yaralandım mən orada. Tabii özüm itidim mən. İtidim, ayıldım ki 24 nəfər sağ adam qalmış kamazın içində.
From the book My Brother's Road, written by Markar Melkonyan, a brother of Monte Melkonyan, an international Armenian terrorist. The soldiers of Aramo and Araba units began firing on the captives and killed them with knives, all without exception. Skar Edo, one of 5 militants of the patriotic unit from Ashtarak, poured petrol and threw the burning match on some of the wounded soldiers. By the moment, Monte approached the ditch in which there were heaps of remains.
Çin deyirlər, Çinlər də biraz böyük. Məsələn, onların başlarını kəsib salafan kloklara yığırdılar.
Mobil Valiyev, one of the hostages, was spared too. He cried out that he had 6 daughters. The Armenian combatants mocked at him and let him free.
Dedilər, düş sən öldürməyəcək. Qaş get. Orada qərib bağ deyilən yer. Düz tut bağı idi. Orada dedilər qaç bir 10 metr qaçmağının ikisi durdu, arxadan avtomat qoydu. Böyle avtomatın daldan piştiler. Her tikəsib tərəfə düşdü.
Vidadi Hüseynov was also among the hostages. The bullet wounded him and didn't kill. He rolled about and fell on the bushes. The Armenians didn't notice him. It was getting dark when Vidadi opened his eyes. A sharp pain pierced through his body. But hearing an Armenian speech, he could hardly contain himself.
Üç tane erməndi, bir de yuxarı bir kent var, cəmiyyət kəndi deyirlər. Ha, bu səslərdən tanım erməniləri. Ki, bu ermənilərdir. Gəldi bir dedi ki, bu belədir, bu elədir, gəl paltarını soyunaq, gəl qulağını kəsək, gəl başını kəsək, gəl paltarını soyunaq, bu ermənilər bir-birinə deyir.
Meanwhile, the lorry with the young hostages reached the Zaki Spring. There, Shamkhal Shirinov notices that those three children whom the Armenian commander put in his own car are out. They don't exist today either. They killed some of the Azerbaijanis near the spring too.
Sinif yoldaşım vardı, Rusiyadan əskərlikdən gəlmişdi, Nəbi, Quliyev Nəbi Mütalifoğlu. Məndən 3 metr aralıqda iştiknoyla diri-diri başını kəsdilər.
Meyitlər də orada elə kəndin qırağında quyu basıb, bizim gözümüz qabanda quyu qazıb basdırdılar orada. Traktoruna.
Və Abdullahını gətirdilər, maşından düşürdü, gətirdi, Kamazın arkasını açdı, başından tapancanı dirədi, dedi, qanı iç. Sən türkün qanını içməlisən. O da götürdü, belə çəkdi üzünə içmədi. O da başından tapancanı dayına vura-vura apardılar, mindirdilər maşına.
Arxada da bir oğlu oturmuşdu və onun maşınla saldılar yeri. Mənim gözümü qabana götürüb makar tapancayla 8 dənəsini onu güllələdilər, onu da meydi orada. Sonra biraz getmişdi, sonra Xəlilov Zahid, yenə də onlar onu orada güllələdilər.
Beginning from Jamiat village, occupied by Armenians to Hankendi, the lorry with hostages was accompanied by Armenian men, women and children who were informed in advance that Azerbaijani hostages would be driven along that road. In order to slake the thirst of these Armenians, the combatants decided to kill another hostage. It was Bayramov Elmidar's turn this time.
Türk istiyorsanız, Müslüman istiyorsanız, onlar da dedi, kışkırdılar, dediler, ha. Öyle orada da onu çürttüler, orada da onu öldürdüler.
They shot with applause. The local Armenians were armed to teeth, with rakes, pitchforks, particular stones.
Hansı soyundurdular, fevral ayının 17'si demeli elimizde kaldı, bir nazi sarışka. Onunla başka hiçbir şey. Lütfen patinkaları çıkarttırıblar. Uşakların elinden hamımızın, ha bir benim yok, hamımızın soyundurdular, ayak yalın bak böyle çorabını.
The hostages were placed in a specially built prison in Hankendi. The next morning they were driven out to the drill square. Chief warders with clubs, combatant with machine guns, and the Armenian audience, who were eager to watch how we would be beaten, mocked and killed.
Orada da ağzıda uzandırdılar bizi yerde karın üstünde. Allah and olsun seherden akşama kimi yönü bu tarafa üstümüzle gelip boynumuzun dalından kimi ki bir beçeri hareket edilir, kundağına vurur.
We were physically and morally tortured. Each step in the passage meant an approaching death, the start of a regular torture, beatings, floggings, outrageous behavior.
Şurak.